just as Christ also loved the church and gave himself up for her, so that he might sanctify her, having cleansed her by the washing of water with the word, that he might present himself to the church in all her glory, having no spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that she would be holy and blameless. So husbands ought to love their own wives as their own bodies. He who loves his own wife loves himself, for no one has ever hated his own body. For this reason a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. This mystery is great. But I am speaking with reference to Christ and the church. Nevertheless, as for you individually, each husband is to love his own wife the same as himself. The wife must see to it that she respects her husband. Jay, do you intend to take this woman? If hand you hold to be your lawfully wedded wife, do you pledge before God and man to be to her a loving and true husband, through good times and bad, keeping yourself to her alone, until death shall separate you? If so, answer I do. Jerry, do you intend to take this man, whose hand you hold, to be your lawfully wedded husband? Do you pledge before God and man to be to him a loving and true wife, through good times and bad, keeping yourself unto him alone, until death separate you? If so, answer I do.
I do.
And I've been told you have your own vow. So, Jay, we will start with you.
She gets to go first.
She gets to go first. Okay. Sherry's going to read her vows that she wrote for Jay.
She's not going to read them because she's coming up with a Bible.
Oh, it's off the top of her head. Okay.
So,
when you stand beside me, I will respect you. When you stand behind me, I will protect you. And if anyone dares stand in front of us, may God have mercy on them. And to quote my good friend Cindy Lauper, I'll be there waiting for you time after time.
Jay, repeat after me. I, Jay, take you, Sherry, to be my wife.
I, Jay, take you, Sherry, to be my wife.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better or for worse, for richer or for poorer.
For better or for worse, for richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health, to love and to cherish.
In sickness and health, to love and to cherish.
Excluding all others.
Excluding all others.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
With God as my witness.
With God as my witness.
I give you my pledge.
I give you my pledge.
Sherry, repeat after me. I, Sherry, take you, Jay, to be my husband.
I, Sherry, take you, Jay, to be my husband.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Excluding all others.
Excluding all others.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
With God as my witness.
With God as my witness.
I give you my pledge.
I give you my pledge.
You have rings?
Chose
to seal your vows by the giving and receiving of rings. The ring forms a perfect circle without a beginning or an end. Thereby it's a symbol of eternity and signifies the duration of the commitment you're making. Let us now exchange rings. Today you have the privilege of placing this ring on Sherry's finger as a sign of the exclusive covenant relationship into which you now enter. Repeat after me. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring
as a symbol of my vow.
And with all that I am, and with all that I am,
and all that I have,
and all that I have,
I will honor you.
I will honor you.
Jerry, you have the privilege of placing this ring on Jay's finger as a sign of an exclusive covenant relationship in which you now enter. Repeat after me. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring
as a symbol of my vow.
As a symbol of my vow.
And with all that I am. With all that I have, I will honor you. Let us pray. Lord, we thank you for the covenant of marriage. between one man and one woman that you created from the beginning. We ask that you bless this marriage between Jay and Sherry that we've witnessed this day. May they always keep you at the center and remember to turn to you for the love and the strength they'll need to remain faithful and true to one another through good times and bad. Lord, bless them. Keep them in your care. In Jesus' name, amen. Now, by the authority vested in me as a minister of the gospel, and in accordance with the laws of the state of Missouri, I now pronounce you man and wife. You may kiss your bride. It's my pleasure to introduce to you for the first time Mr. and Mrs. Jesse Barron Crutchfield, Jr.
Hold on to me tighter as the summer sun got high.